Let's talk about theater of the absurd. Now, absurd theater is a beautiful, wonderful, strange theater movement that arose following World War II. After such an impactful thing like war, people are hurt, are confused, they're emotional, and they need a place to express those feelings. So Albert Camus and Jean-Paul Sartre started the existential movement right after World War I that functioned on the basis that life is meaningless, that there is no God, and that the only thing that we can do is be responsible for our own deeds. Now, theater of the absurd branched off from this school of thought, and much of what absurdist theaters were commenting on was the question, what do we do if life is meaningless? The options are move forward in the face of meaninglessness and absurdity of life, or commit suicide. And we all know suicide isn't really an option, because what if Godot comes? Now, absurd theater puts an emphasis on the breakdown of communication, how we all talk but we're not really saying anything. The conversations move in circles, lines are frequently repeated by the actors, subjects are dropped suddenly, characters completely ignore one another, and exchanges are short and often unanswered questions. One of my favorite absurdist plays is Endgame by Samuel Beckett, and it centers around the two characters of Clove and Ham. Now, these two men are stuck in a cyclical existence, so beginnings and endings are so linked that they can't be escaped. Clove is forever saying he's going to leave Ham, but can't seem to actually leave. Now, how often have any of us done the same thing? How many times have I longed, yearned, grasped for something, but haven't done anything to make it a reality? And Clove, like many of us, longs to leave, but remains. Now, absurd theater packs some pretty poignant punches on points like this. Now, it may seem like a sad existence, but I think it's poetic. There's courage in living. And, in the words of Beckett, you must go on. I can't go on. I'll go on.